no flesh and soul between, and please enjoy.
Still no news.
None last night, none this morning.
3 days without news. Strange indeed.
Our messengers go out, our messengers return, and always they shake their heads and say,
nothing.
They've come the whole countryside. What more can be done?
We can only wait. There's no use meeting trouble halfway. Perhaps he'll return as abruptly as he left us.
When I saw him leaving the palace, I noticed a queer look in his eyes.
Yes, so did I. In fact, I asked him what was amiss.
Did he answer?
One word.
Nothing.
It's all very disturbing.
Oh, come now. All young fellows are like that.
You're right there. They take things hard. But time smooths everything out.
Do you really think so?
Of course. For one girl dead, a dozen living ones.
What else should there be? Anyhow, grief never lasts forever. Is any one of us capable of mourning a loss for more than 1 year on end?
Anyhow.
No one can do that.
Life would be intolerable if one could.
Quite so. But happily, it doesn't amount to much.
Yes, nature is a great healer.
Well?
Still. Nothing.
Come now. There's no need for consternation.
I agree.
We're in Wolfman Malice, and it's lunchtime.
That is so. We mustn't drop the prey for the shadow.
I agree, but I don't like the looks of things. But all is going too smoothly, as an emperor wants perfection itself.
Yes, exactly the emperor wanted. Conscious and inexperienced.
But what's come over you? We have no grounds for assuming he will change. Let's say he loved Drusilla. Only natural, she was his sister.
Or say his love for her was something more than brotherly. Shocking enough, I grant you.
But it's really going too far setting all Rome in a turmoil because a girl has died.
Yeah, I agree. But as I said, I don't like the looks of things. Excessively.
Yeah, there is never smoke without fire.
In any case, the interest of the state should prevent this making a public tragedy of, let's say, a regrettable attachment. No doubt such things happen, but the less said, the better.
How can you be sure that Drusilla is the cause of all this trouble?
Who else should it be?
Well?
Nothing.
Some peasants think they saw him last night, rushing through the storm, not far from Rome.
That makes 3 days here, doesn't it?
He went up to Drusilla's body and stroked it with his fingers. As he left the cloth for a long while, then he swung out and walked out, calmly enough. And ever since, we've been hunting for him in vain.
That man was too fond of her. He's of literature.
Oh, at his age, you know.
At his age, perhaps, but not in his position. An artistic emperor is a novelist.
One man, one job. That's how it should be.
What can you do right
now? Nothing.
We can only wait. If he doesn't return, a successor will have to be found. There is no shortage of candidates.
No, but there's a shortage of the right sort.
Suppose he comes back in an ugly mood.
Oh, he's a mere boy. We'll make him see reason.
What if he refuses? refuses to see it.
In that case, my friend, don't forget I once wrote a manual of revolutions. You'll find all the rules there.
I'd rather be left in my place.
If you'll excuse me.
She's offended.
Scipio is young, and young people always hang together.
Impossible.
Why?
If I sleep, in the moon,
can't deceive me.
Understand?
And please, help me from now on.
No reason not to do so, guys. But I know very few things, and few things interest me. What way can I help?
In the way of the impossible. Really, you should be thankful to me. I play exactly to your own hands and with your own hearts.
There is much of a genius in the simplicity of my plan, which actually clinches the matter. Now, I give you 3 seconds in which you can remove yourself from my presence.
I can't believe this. But it was all just a joke, wasn't it? All you said.
Not quite, sorry. Let's say it was a lesson in statesmanship.
But Carlos, it's impossible.
That's the whole point now, my dear, isn't it?
I don't follow.
That's my point. Exploiting is impossible. Or rather, should I say, I'm trying to make it impossible.
But he may do anything. It's a lunatic's best time.
No, Scythia! It's art! It's an emperor's vocation! At last, I've come to see the uses of supremacy. It gives impossibilities forever. From this day on, as long as life is mine, my freedom shall have no frontier.
I wonder if the discovery of yours will make us any happier.
So do I. But we'll just have to live it through now, won't we? Now leave me, Scythia. Go! Go and spread the news in Rome that freedom has been given her at last. And with it, begins a great probation.
Crying?
Yes, Cesare, I'm crying.
But what has changed in your life? You may have loved Lucilla, but you have loved many other women, including myself. Of course, it was never enough to set you on the countryside for 3 days and nights and bring you back with this cruel look at your face.
What nonsense is this? Why are you crying, Lucilla?
I'm sorry.
You think that love is the only thing that can make men shed tears? Men weep because the world's all wrong.
At my age, one knows what life's in business, but why the bigger is it out to make it worse?
You can't understand. I knew that men felt anguish. But I didn't know what that word anguish meant. Like everyone else, I fancied it was sickness of the mind and no more. But no! It's my body that's in pain. Pain everywhere. In my arms. In my chest, in my mouth. It's queer taste to my mouth. It's not blood. It's not fever. It's not death. But a miserable dream. How cruel is this process of becoming a man? That fellow was quite right, you know. It's only the treasury that counts. The fountainhead of all. At last I'm going to live. Really live. And living, my dear, is the opposite of love. I know what I'm talking about. They're invited to the most gorgeous of shows. A sight for most of our time. A whole world put to judgment. I need crowds. Spectators. Pictures. Criminals. Hundreds and thousands of them. I will show them something they've never seen before. The one true free man in the Roman Empire. And you, Cesario, shall obey me. You must invite me to the end. It will be marvelous. You see, swear to set my hands on you.
I didn't swear. You know I love you.
You do all I tell you?
All.
You'll be cruel.
Cruel.
Golden ruthless.
Ruthless.
And you suffer too.
Yeah. No, please! I'm going back!
You see, my dear? No one left. No one to remember. No man. Nothing. No, that's not true. Look, Sidonia! Look!
Caligula!
Yes! Caligula!
The way he's treating us.
He calls me darling in public, mind you, just to make a laughing stock of me. Conduct like that is quite inexcusable.
You're right. That's precisely the sort of thing one can't forgive.
He confiscates our property. He kills our fathers and sons. He's taking away our beauty. I ask you, can you endure this?
He had Scipia's mind made up when he had her father put to death.
Well, can you still hesitate?
No, we are with you.
He's a coward, a bully, a
What's this? Where are you all going?
To the palace.
Ah, that's why. Do you think you'll be allowed to enter?
There is no question about the king.
It is not so simple as you think, my friends. You are afraid, but fear alone cannot take place of courage and deliberation. In short, we reckon to cost it.
If you're not with us, go, but keep your mouth shut.
I suspect we're with you. Make no mistake, not for the same reasons.
It's an impossible title,
Doctor. I agree. Let's get down to the facts. But first, let me make myself clear. I believe you haven't taken your enemy's measure, since you still attribute petty motives to him. And there's nothing petty about Caligula, and you're riding for a fall. You'd be better placed to fight him if you saw him as he really is.
You see him as he is, a great guy.
No, we have had experience of bad emperors before, but this one isn't bad enough. What I want from him is this, he knows what he wants.
We too know what he wants to murder us all!
You're wrong! Our death is only a side issue. He's putting his power in the service of all here, a deadly passion, and it imperils every hope of sacred. True, it is not the first time the prophet said a man will use power, but it's the first time he says no misuse of it, and God of mankind, and the world goes for nothing. That's what the false Caligula. That's what It's not great ever. I will have the courage to lose my head if time comes. But I cannot tolerate to see for one's life is being drained of meaning. And many men have to the reason for living.
Revenge is a good reason.
Yes, it is. And I propose to share it with you. But remember this. It's not on your account or to avenge your petty humiliations. No. If we join forces, it's to combat a big idea. An ideal, if you like. Whose triumph will mean the end of everything. We can endure being made a mock of, but we cannot endure Caligula putting his theories into practice. He's turning his philosophy into corpses, and it's a philosophy that's logical, from start to finish. And when one can't refute, one strikes.
Yes, we must act.
I agree, but a direct attack is quite useless when one is fighting an imperial madman in full flush of power. All I want, gain some peace of mind in a world that has retained its meaning.
It spurs me on his hand of vision but fear. My very reasonable fear of that human vision which my life is no more than a speck of dust.
Yes, I understand what you mean. And anyhow, it's good that you too feel that the whole society is threatened.
Our only motive is of a moral folder. Many life is breaking down, men are losing respect for their honest work. Way of morality sweeping the country. Would you be deaf at the appeal of our ancestral piety in its hour of danger?
Fellow conspirators, can you endure this situation where patricians are obliged to run around the emperor's litter like slaves?
Will you endure to be called darling in public and have their beauty snatched from them?
And their money?
No!
Kaya, Mushin, your advice is good. And you did well to calm our passion.
The time is not yet right for action. The mess is still against us.
Will you join us in waiting for the best moment to strike? Let's strike hard.
Yes. And meanwhile, let Caligula follow his rage. Let's put some metal into his madness. And then, a day will come. He's going to be a lonely man in an empire of the dead. Kinsmen of death.
Good day, darlings. I'm on my way to an execution. But I thought to drop in and see you, Caria. My stupendous fact that there are so many of you here, that someone is going to be executed. What's this? Another messenger who is going to be executed? Good for you. I found on you that a man without he had done anything for him to die. Fear is a noble emotion, pure and simple, self-sufficient. It draws its patent of nobility straight from the gods.
Bro, let's change the subject. Can
you be silent? What have you to say?
I'm quite ready to speak, guys. Will you give me leave?
Excellent. Then keep silent. I would rather hear a word from our beloved friend, Mushis.
As you will, guys.
Then, tell us something about your wife.
Mushis, you're waiting.
My wife? I'm very fond of her.
Of course. So original, so unordinary.
By the way,
when I just came in, you were catching a plot, a nice bloody window plot, weren't you? I know that not one of you has the spunk for a heroic act. Not one of you has the guts to do that.
I have some sleep questions. But first, let me create the desires that nature creates in us every way.
Mushas! Now, as I told Kiria, tell us everything was happening here just before we came in.
With pleasure, my dear sister. Our quarrel arose from a discussion whether poetry should be bloodthirsty or not.
It surprised me that your passion for poetry should make you come to blows.
Well, true. But I remember Caligula saying the other day that all true passion has a spice of blows.
There's still in that. Don't you agree?
Yes.
should definitely put his ideas into writing if they would be involved.
What's more? Keep him busy. He obviously needs something to occupy his time.
You're replacing him. The people are working on a board. Quite a big one, I suppose.
Lucius, I return your life with many thanks, but excuse me, I have some orders to give.
Play book of gifts. Will rank among our learning classes. Are you listening, Lucius?
Yes, my name. What is it?
We assume it deals with the murderous power of poetry.
Something of that sort, I suppose. But there is one thing. You won't like quite so much about that book.
What is it?
Its title, Cold Steel.
Excuse me, I have some words of public work in hand. I have signed a decree to that effect. You will find it in my study. Now, with Helicon's assistance, we'll be putting the final touches of a monograph about the execution, about which she will have much to say.
Assuming we ask your opinion,
why not be generous, Helicon, and introduce them into our little secrets? Give them a sample. Section 3, first paragraph.
Execution relieves and liberates. It is tonic, universal, just in principle, and in practice. A man dies because he is guilty. A man is guilty because he is a legal subject. Now all men are legal subjects, ergo all men are guilty and shall die. It is only a matter of time and patience.
There is logic for you, don't you agree? That bit about patience was rather weak. Allow me to tell you, that's the quality most people admire in you. Your patience. Now that you know this person, Helena doesn't need your presence any longer. Zonia, I wish you to stay. I wish to hear your thoughts about the national problem. It's not functioning to work. Go!
But I
think
that you need to be too.
Helena! Writing more poems, I suppose.
Yes, Caesar. I've been writing more poems.
On what subject?
On nothing in particular. Well, on nature, in a way.
A fine and the last one. What has nature done for you?
It consoles me for not being Caesar.
Really? And you think it would console me for being Caesar?
Why not? Nature is still worse with than that.
Once you said there was anger in your voice because I put your father to death. If you only knew how it would happen, this man would. Well, there is something I hated for developing the intelligence.
I answered your question about nature.
Recite your point, please.
No, please not ask me that.
Why not?
I haven't got it on me.
Can't you remember it?
No.
Anyhow, you can tell me what is it about.
It spoke of a certain harmony.
Between one's feet and the earth?
Yes. It's almost that. And it entered the way the outlines of the Roman hills. And the sudden thrill of things that the twilight brings to them.
And the tides of swifts rising with the green dust.
Yes, yes. And the fantastic moment when the sky reflected red and golden swings and showed its other side, spangled in stars.
And the faint smell of streams and trees that mingles with the rising mist.
Yes, yes. And the chirp of crickets, the coolness beneath the warm air, dogs barking. And the farmer's shouts.
And the shadow of throats to the olive groves.
Yes, exactly. But how did you know?
I wonder. Perhaps because the same eternal truths appear to us both.
Anyhow, what does it matter? All I know is that all I think of and touch, first love.
That sleep is a privilege of noble hearts, and how I wish I could share it, but my appetite for life is too keen. Nature could never satisfy you. You're too young to understand. You are single-minded for good, and I'm single-minded for evil.
I do understand.
No! There is something deep down in me. An abyss of silence, a pool of stagnant water, rotting weeds. Your poem sounds very good to me, but if you really want my opinion,
yes.
That's all a little bit what I know.
You lost a brute! You fooled me again! You played a trick on me, and now you're gloating over your success!
You're right, I was playing a part.
What a foul black heart you have! And how the weakness and hatred must make you suffer!
That's enough!
How I loathe you! And how I pity you!
Enough, I tell you!
And how hard for the loneliness that yours must be!
Loneliness! What do you know? Only the loneliness of poets and weaklings! You break of loneliness, but you don't realize that one is never alone! Always we are attended by the same world of future and past! Those we can kill, but always we ask what they are doing to each other! It's those we can love! Those who love us and whom we did not love, regrets, desires, bitterness and swiftness, wars and guns, the celestial game, always. Always with us. So it is, no, Scipia. Mine is full of gnashing of teeth. Hideous with jeering sounds and voices. And when I am with the women, I make mine. Darkness falls on us, and I think now my body has shed its fill, poised between life and death. Then my solitude is fouled by the stale smell of pleasure from the woman sprawling at my sight.
world or heaven, born emperor known to men as Caligula. Draw near, mortals of common clay, by a divine dispensation peculiar to Caligula celebrate. The secrets of the gods shall be revealed upon you.
Come and adore him, gentlemen, to the heaven and its secrets I have sold at a price to each pocket.
For all to see the secrets of Olympus' revelation in high places, featuring gods in undressed their lips of blondes and friends. Sway the whole truth about your gods.
Come here, gentlemen. The show has begun.
in the Roman Empire for only 5 golden pieces for each and every 20 minutes. And that's a bargain. Look at them. Aren't they beautiful? Superb! The most lascivious ladies in the Roman Empire come today to perform their patriotic duties for all. Only 5 golden pieces shall give that they remember you well. Follow aboard the Imperial Bordello. You have a choice of the finest flesh in the whole empire. For only 5 golden pieces, for each and every 20 minutes, and get a bargain here. Because most of these women are respectable married ladies, senators' wives, force of blameless reputation. Don't waste time. These women are not only beautiful, they're insatiable. Take the rights of those who summon you. Take the wives, use them, abuse them, do as you will with them. They're yours. Now, you may go.
Mind you, that there's only left. I have posted sentries in the others with orders to kill you.
Go! Can I go?
Yes, guys.
Getting on with the task?
What task?
You know, the moon.
Oh, yes, the moon.
It's a matter of time and patience, but I'd like to have a word with you. I might have patience. When I have much time, so you must make haste.
I said that to my outpost. I have some very serious news to tell you.
Mind you, I'm here already. The moon!
Yes, it is the moon. Listen, there is a flood being cast against your life.
What's more, I have it 2 or 3 times to be sure. Still, I hear it all right.
For the last hour I've been trying to tell you. Only
this last summer, I've been gazing at her so long and stroking her so hard on the marble pillows in the gardens. But evidently, she can't understand.
Please stop trifling, Gaius. Even if you refuse to listen, it is my duty to tell you what I've learned. And if you shut your ears, it cannot be helped.
It was a cloudless all this night. She was coiled to begin with, and not too bad. First, she was blood red, low on the horizon. Then she began rising, quicker and quicker, growing brighter and brighter all the while. And the higher she climbed, the paler she grew, till she was like a milky pool, and the night was rustling with stars. Slowly, shyly, she approached through the warm night air. Soft, light as a pearl, naked in beauty. She crossed the threshold of my room, glided to my bed, poured herself into it, and flooded me with her smiles and sheen. So, see, Caledon, I can say without boasting that I've had her.
I'll be listen and learn the danger that is threatening your life.
All I want, Caledon, is the moon. For the rest, I've always known what to cure me. I haven't yet exhausted all the history in my life. And that's why I want the moon. And you must not return till you have secured her for me!
Very well. Now I shall do my duty and tell you what I've learned. There is a plot against you. Aria is the ringleader. I came across this tablet, which tells you all you need to know. See? I put it here.
Where are you off to, Caledon?
Get the moon for you.
No, Gabriel. Then are you sure you need my
sure, Harriet. I'm sorry for seeming so inhospitable. I was following up my thoughts and... Now, do sit down. We have a friendly little chat, you and I. I'm in the mood for some intelligent conversation. Do you think, Harriet, that it's possible for two men of much the same temperament and equal pride to talk to each other like complete friends? If only one thing to their wives, can they strip themselves naked, so to speak, shed their prejudices, their private interests, the lies by which they live?
Yes, Captain. I think it's possible. But I don't think you're capable.
You're right. I don't want you to look too great with me. So, let's wear our masks and muster up our lies, and we talk as fencers fight, based on our vital parts. Tell me, Carrier, why don't you like me? I've told you why.
Because you're noxious and cruel, vain, selfish. Because I understand you far too well. One cannot like an aspect of oneself which one tries to keep concealed.
But then, why did you hate me?
There, guys, you're mistaken. I do not hate you. Simply consider you a nuisance, a constant menace. I, like most men, like and need, feel secure. We resent living in a world where the most preposterous of fantasies can at any point struggle through our hearts like a dagger. I refuse to live at the top of the world. I want to know where I stand. I want to stand secure.
Security and logic. Don't go together.
Quite true. My plan for life may not be logical, but at least it's sound. Go on. There's nothing more to say. I'll be no party to your logic. I know my duties as a man. And I also know that the majority of your subjects share my view. You resent their deepest feelings. It's only natural. You should disappear.
I see your point, and it's legitimate enough. For most men I grant you, it's obvious. But you should have known better. You're an intelligent man. And given intelligence, one has a choice. Either to pay its price or disarm it. Why do you shirk the issue and neither consent to pay its price? No disarm it.
Because all I want is to live and to be happy. None of those are possible if one pushes the absurd to its logical conclusions. That is what matters to me.
But why risk your life? What tell you this?
Because others will take my place. Because I don't like lying.
Carrier.
Yes, guys.
Do you think that two men of similar temperament and equal pride can talk to each other with complete frankness if only once in their lives?
That, guys, I believe is just what we've been doing.
Yes, Harriet. But you thought I was incapable of it.
I was wrong. And I thank you. Now, I await your sentence.
But I cannot go to the
beach. You are with him?
No! But I don't get a view of him. killed him. My heart could still be with him.
And yet, killed your father.
Yes, and that's how it all began. But that too is how it ends.
Denies what you believe in. He trembles on all you hold sacred.
I know, Maria. And yet something inside of me is akin to him. The same fire burns in both of our hearts.
You know, there is a time when a man must make a choice. As for me, I have silenced in my heart anything that might be akin to him.
But I cannot make a choice. I have my own sorrow. But I suffer with him too. I share his pain. I understand it all. That is my horror.
So you've just chosen to take his side.
I beg you, don't do that. I cannot go never again in anyone's side.
You know, I think you've done more. Having made the view, this.
Yes, he has taught me to expect everything of life.
No, he has taught you despair. To have instilled despair in such a young heart is fouler than the foulest of crimes he has committed up to now. That alone would justify me killing him.
Ah, Maria, I've been hunting for you high and low. Nino is giving a little market for his personal friends only. Naturally, he expects you to know it. The guests will be arriving shortly.
Maria,
yes.
Try to understand.
No.
Goodbye, dear guys.
What did she say?
Nothing you would understand.
What are you thinking of?
About her and about you, but it amounts to the same thing.
What's the matter?
Skipjan is gone to win your friendship, but I wonder why you're still here.
Why? Because you're fond of me.
No. But I think I would understand if I had you killed.
Yes. That would be a solution. Do so bad. But why can't you relax? And who would go on? Live freely, without constraints.
I've been doing that for quite a while, in fact, I made a practice.
I don't mean that sort of freedom. I mean, don't you realize? What is it to live and love quite simply, happily, in the purity of heart?
This purity of heart you talk of every man acquires it in his own way. Mine has been to follow the essential till the end. Still, all that didn't prevent me from putting you to death. It would round off my career so well, the perfect climax. When I don't kill, I feel alone. The living don't suffice to people and dispel my boredom. I have an impression of an enormous void when you and the others are here and I see nothing but empty air.
No, I'm a genius only in the company of my dead. Only the dead of me. I have long talks. This man, that man, the man who screamed to me for mercy and whose tongue I had cut out.
Come, put your head on my knee. Isn't it bad? How quiet?
Quiet? You exaggerate, my dear. Listen, you hear those thousands of small sounds all around us. Hatred stalking its prey.
Nobody would dare.
Yes, stupidity
doesn't kill. It makes men fall to death.
Every murderous soldier, a fool stops at nothing when his dignity is offended. No, it's not the sons or fathers of the men who have been killed that will murder me. They have understood me. They have the same taste in their mouths, but the others. Those I've made a laughing stock of, I have no defense against their wounded vanity.
We'll defend you. They're still made up of love you.
Fewer every day.
But it's not surprising.
I've done all that was needed to an end. But then let's be fair. Such stupidity that escapes me is the courage and simple faith of man who has to be happy.
They will not kill you. If they try, fire will come down from heaven and bless them.
From heaven? There is no heaven, my poor dear mom. Why this sudden absence of devotion? It wasn't provided for in our agreement, as I remember rightly.
Don't you understand? Don't you realize? Has it been enough to see you killing others without knowing that one day you as well will be killed? I see you cold and ruthless every day when you hold me in your arms. I smell the smell of and the ring of murder when you lie to me. Day after day, I see everything is human die out in you. I just want you to get well. Just get well again. Really, you're just a boy. You have all your life ahead of you. And what more possibly would you ever want than a whole life?
You've been with me a long time now. A very long time.
That's all. But you'll keep me with you, won't you?
I do not know. I only know that if you are with me still, it's because of all those nights we had together. Nights of tears, joyous pleasure. Because you alone know me as I am.
They were nonetheless my life seemed so filled of my past selves and shreds so complete in fact, you remained the last witness. And I can't avoid a sort of tenderness for the woman that you are.
Tell me that you mean to keep me with you.
I do not know. All I know, it is the most terrible thing of all, is that this tenderness
The one sincere emotion that my life has given up to now. Shouldn't the last witness disappear?
It doesn't matter. What you said made me very happy. And all I know is that I'm happy. Why can't I not share my happiness with you?
Who says I'm happy?
Happiness is kind. It doesn't thrive on bloodshed.
Then there must be two kinds of happiness. And I saw them the murderous man, for I am happy. Look at me! It makes me laugh, Zoya. Quite a thing of half years and years. Oro, careful, avoid it after Drusilla's name.
Well, Oro, who is taken? Love isn't enough for me. I realized it then, and I realize it now. When I look at you, to love someone means that one's willing to grow old beside that person. Well, that sort of love is right outside my range. Drusilla old would have been much worse than Drusilla dead.
Most people imagine that out of the blue, death snatches away the Roman hero.
But no! His real suffering is less futile. It comes from the discovery that grief too cannot last. Your grief is vanity.
You see? I have no excuses, not the shadow of a real love, no profound bitterness, nor regret. Nothing to plead in my defense, but today you see me freer than I've ever been, freed from memories and illusions. I know now that nothing, nothing lasts! Think what that knowledge means, Sonia. It have been just two or three of us in history who really achieved this freedom, this crazy happiness. You see now the most unusual drama, and it's the time the curtain fell for you.
No! How can you call this happiness? This terrifying freedom!
Happiness, it is, Sonia. I know what I'm saying, but to achieve it, I have been a contented man, and thanks to it, I have won it. God-like power.
I lived, I killed, I exercised a rapturous power on the sword compared to which the power of the agents of the other child's day. And this is happiness! This is nothing else!
No, 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 time is very short, time is very short, so you're not on that turn. You two were guilty, but killing was not the solution.
You two are guilty. Yet, who can condemn me in this world where nobody is innocent, where there is no judge? You see, Hiroko, you have failed me. I won't hit the moon, but never,
But how bitter it is to know all, and to go to the house of confirmation.
Listen, this is our friends. Innocence not made for the free. Innocence for the triumph.
Why am I not among them, in their places? And I'm not free. That's cruelest of all. After despising others to find oneself as cowardly as they.
Still, no matter, fear too has an end. Soon I shall attain this emptiness beyond all understanding in which the heart has rest.
Yes, really. It's quite simple. If I had a moon, if love were enough, all might have been different. There's nothing in this world, or in the other, made to my taste.
Yet I know, you two know still weeping that all I wanted was impossible. It's impossible, I searched for it at the confines of the world, at the secret places of my heart. I even stretched out my hands.
See? I stretch out my hands. But it's only you I find. You're confronting me, and I've come to change you.
I've chosen the wrong path. A path that leads to nothing. My freedom isn't the right one.
Come, Christmas is starting this. Here they come. Here they come.